Hello everybody, thank you for watching to a new episode of the Easing E58 How to Improve the Wi-Fi FPV Range. It really needs to be upgraded after we did the 2W signal booster to the transmitter and the SMA connector modification. And now we like to have the Wi-Fi FPV of the Easing E58 go the same distance as with the new modifications that we made to the transmitter. And I thought it was going to be a really easy modification to the Easing E58 to get the Wi-Fi FPV range to improve by a whole bunch. I was doing just a simple modification that we did to the transmitter, and that was adding an SMA connector extension lead to the Wi-Fi FPV module that luckily comes with an Apex connector, so we don't even have to solder, it's just plug and play. And then having the dipole antenna sticking on top of the drone, and as you already can see, I already tried it twice and it didn't work out because I wasn't able to trim the drone so it stayed in one place. It was always drifting away, and theoretical it should work because the dipole antenna together with the SMA connector weighs together 30 grams, and I already did a lift test that shows that 30 grams was the maximum for the E58 to carry and still be able to fly really good. So the only solution that I have to extend the Wi-Fi FPV range of the E58 is using a similar lightweight antenna. And these three antennas are omnidirectional and 3 dBi. These two antennas are 4 dBi, but they are patch antennas, so that's not really gonna work. And this is 5 dBi, but it's also a patch antenna. And the problem with a patch antenna is that you can have 100 range one way, but if you turn the crowd 45 degrees, you can lose all the range. So these we are not going to try out because they are not really useful for a drone that flies in all directions. That leaves us with 3 dBi antennas that we can use, and I would like to use the one with the longest wire, but I found they sent me a dot. There's a slight issue, and that this is the positive wire that should come out of the top, like this positive wire broke off or something, but it's gone. This antenna got the same thing, but there's heat shrink over it. But I'm gonna try to connect this antenna to the Wi-Fi FPV module that also has an Apex connector, so we don't have to solder. It's gonna be a very easy modification, but we have to do the first step, and that is disassembly the full drone. And if you don't know how to disassemble the E58, then I will be linking a video up over here that shows you step by step how to do it. And when you have your Easing E58 fully disassembled, then you can be finding the antenna, Wi-Fi module antenna, sitting right over here that we somehow have to seem to get out of there, and then unplug it. And the stock antenna looks very similar to the 3 dBi antenna that we bought from Banggood, so I think it's 3 dBi. It didn't say in the description, so I'm not 100% sure. I'm gonna use this 3 dBi antenna that I found on Banggood because it got a little bit more protection for the positive wire. And the second trick is I'm gonna drill an opening as close to the Apex connector as possible, so we can have the wire and the antenna sticking out the bottom side as far as possible. That's the hole. Now just we're gonna run the wire to the bottom and connect that to the Apex connector. Holy cow, that was a fig leaf job, but we made it. It's sitting there, it's connected, you hear that knick, and you know it's not going to move. So now we have the antenna running free underneath the drone, giving us a lot better connection and hopefully a lot more range that we are going to test. There's one little thing that you have to be careful for when the Apex connector wire, this little wire has to hug the body so that the battery can shift and doesn't get hooked up by the wire. And then you can start rebuilding the drone, and then you test if everything still works. And you can see that the Wi-Fi FPV works and the motors are working, so that's all perfectly fine. That makes now time to go outside and do the range test for the Wi-Fi FPV and how far we can fly the drone with the phone. And hopefully we get a better signal with the Wi-Fi analyzer, so we can find the drone a lot easier and a lot faster, and get more range than the 30 minutes that we have now. But that will be coming up in the next episode, so I really hope you subscribe for that and click the notification bell so you will be notified when the video will be released. And it will help me a lot if you give this video a like, thumbs ups, and I'm going to say goodbye. Thank you all for watching, and hope to see you next time. And keep on flying.